They responded, Jesus, for those who are demon-possessed, we pray. Wow, there's so many. We'll go again, we'll go again. That's what the church will always do. But Jesus says, hold on. Hold on. Let's take a break. Let's withdraw. Let's go into solace. Because the crowd will always be there. Remember? Then after the feeding of 5,000 came again. People were always following them. See, we think that is success. Success sometimes can be a bane to us when we do not know how to control success. We don't know how to ask God. We don't know how to get rest. And we forget that it's God who does the work and not us. So stillness helps. That's why in the place when Moses knew, when Moses has done all that he had done and entered in the promised land, he saw God and says, God, after doing all this, I know it's not me, it's you. Unless your presence goes with me, I will not move. And where your presence is, I will be there. That is holy space. That's where you learn to turn to the Lord all the time. Fourthly, it's a place of rest. It's a place of quiet trusting and not feverish manipulation. Many times I feel, I come back, I'm always guilty of doing that. In the church, we have the ought and the should. To be holy, you ought to do this. To be holy, you should be doing this. So we put a lot of unrealistic expectations on people. To be a good Christian, you must do this. To be a good Christian, you must do that. But I think there are boundaries that we need to know how to draw. Because for Singaporeans especially, modern Protestant church, you are very good in what you call the performance mode. You're very good in doing performance mode. Perform, 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 perform. We're thinking that performance will drive us to better results. Sometimes it doesn't. Sometimes I think we only try to do what you call to achieve more and by pushing more ourselves. I'm not saying that we should not have goals and aims and have desire. When God empowers you, go all the way to serve Him. But when you're tired, you know how to pull back and says, I know how to rest. I was saying to some of us, some things we can control, but many things we cannot control. So what do? They that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. The waiting is very hard for us. It's the active waiting we look on God. When God says go, we go. When God says stop, we better stop. Do we learn this? Lastly, it's a place for wholeness. When you come into contact with God, it's a place for transformation. It's a place of transfiguration. When you enter, when you see God face to face, I can tell you what happens. Something happens within you. Let me tell you this. Tonight, I see, look at some of you. You know you have a good relationship with God. You're very healthy inside. Huh? And when you relate to people, you are not agitated, you know. Even people are very angry with you for no reason sometimes. But you know how to hold yourself. You are calm yourself. That's why you bring serenity and peace to the environment. Because you are whole, you bring wholeness to people. But if that night you're agitated, if that night you're so angry in a situation, you come to a prayer meeting and the pastor talks to you, I can tell you this, I can see all the anger and the angst that they will be exploding inside. Same thing. When you come to God, when you're able to have that relationship, have that space for God in Christ alone, then you will be changed. I will tell you this, one story, and I'll close. My prayer is very simple. I can lead you in this story because that will relate to you. When I was in Melbourne, I was there in the chapel, and there's a great desire for me because I prayed the prayer, God, give me the desire to desire. And I really desired. And said, I really want to see you, God. I want to see your glory. I'm learning to pray, oh God, just like Moses. Where your presence is, I want to be there. I want to hear you. I really want to delight in you. God, I love you. And so what happens is that I was just seated, you know, normally behind. And I began to move forward. I was drawn to God, to the cross, the crucifix. And the crucifix in the Catholic Church, they have this face of Jesus. And He looks at you really in the eye. He was a very good one. He looks at you in the eye and says, where are you? I'm here, Lord Jesus. So I move. every day I moved forward. Until a day, I was moving up to this area, you know. And normally, we don't move up to this area because this is where the priest normally will have the table and Holy Sacrament. But my priest tells me, it's okay if God draws you. So I went, I sat at the priest's chair, where the priest normally sits there. I sat there for 2 days, and I was looking at the cross. Every time, Christ was telling me, I know you desire me. I know you desire me. And every time I sat there, and sometimes midnight, I can't sleep, I will go to chapel alone. I'll be sitting there on the light, I'll look at the cross. One day, something strange happens to me. I look at the cross, and the cross is higher than this, maybe above the top of that cross, and it's up, high up, okay? And I need to climb on the chair to touch the crucifix. And Christ looks at me as if, you know, looking at me, he says, you know, God, you look always on the cross so high, and you know I love you, and I'm a person who likes to touch, and I see. I says, can I touch you? It's just like a heart been drawn, like you look at a stone, so flower, so nice, you want to touch. It says, do not touch, but your heart says, must touch, kind of thing. So here is a chapel, and there are two or three retreatants praying there, and I was up there, looking at the cross, and then there's a voice that comes to mind. You want to touch me? Come, touch me. I says, sure or not? This is a Catholic church, you know. And then I turned around. Wow, God, two or three persons there, you know. And I said, God, you sure you want me to do this? Do you desire? I says, God, I want. It's your desire, not about the thing. It's your own spirit telling you. I said, I desire. But people praying, looking at the cross, how to touch you? The God says, are you scared? Wow, God, you challenged me. I want to, God. So what happened was, I went up there, and then I took the chair, the chair that was there, I put the chair, I says, okay, I do a fast one, Lord. 1 second, I come up and touch, and then come down. I took the chair, I went up, I touched the feet of the crucifix, that is the figure, I touched the feet. And I held there still for 10 seconds. I says, I think it's enough, better come down, otherwise I'll be stoned. I came down, people just quiet, maybe they were shocked, but quiet. Then again the voices, why so fast? Touch again. God, now, would you want? I want to, God. I went, touch again. This time around was longer. I tell you what happens. There was a connection in my spirit. Because I said, I desire. God will put you to a test. Do you really desire? It's going to be a shame. It's going to be very funny because you don't do this in a Catholic church. I did that. I touched that. I got connected. Somehow my spirit broke and says, my God, that intimacy, the experience of closeness to God begins to take shape because I desire that. I desire more than anything else because I says, God, if people will laugh at me, it's okay. After that, tomorrow, normally we have to report to the priest what happened the night before in the experience. So I have to report to my priest. I said, priest, last night I do a very strange thing. I don't know whether is it right to do in a Catholic church. I climb up on this chair and I touch the crucifix. I touch Christ's feet as in that language. He looked at me and smiled. If God tells you to do so, do it. I was, thank God. Friends, I'm asking you for holy space tonight. The holy space is not something outside. It's inside. Anywhere can be a place because Teresa of Avila, it was in the middle of the kitchen when she was doing all the noisy things. God was there. Have you been in the kitchen when you can sing praise to God? God was there. It's your spirit. Any place that you create to be sacred, and you long for God there, it becomes a sacred place. It's your heart. You can create a place and your heart is not there, it is still a very dull place, it still be a very quiet place. But when your heart is aflame with the love of God, any place you go to, it becomes sacred. Like Moses went up to Mount Sinai, it was a holy place. It was an ordinary mountain, it was there before creation, it was there in creation, and God created it, nobody was up there. The tent